Hi. About a couple of months ago, we sent a survey to some 1,000 people in our mailing list. So the idea of the survey is to try to understand what are the general pain points or challenges that's been faced by the Microsoft BizTalk Server customers. Out of the 1,000 people we contacted, about 200 of them responded back, which is a really astonishing number, given these days you get a lot of spam messages and people really don't spend time to respond to any of them. So about 200 people responded, and if you look at the format of the survey itself, just 5 questions, 4 of them are general option checkbox type questions, easily you can select it. But one question, we left it intentionally like an open-ended one. We just asked, what is your number one pain point? And with a big text box. And to our surprise, a lot of people took time to respond to that by putting their pain points in a couple of paragraphs and some lengthy, really lengthy ones. So we analyzed all of them, and then we kind of identified a different buckets, like what are the real pain points, which areas of the product the customers are having pain points. So the number one pain point, what majority of the people responded, is around deployment, configuration, and administration. So one of them in that area. So people find it really difficult today for you to deploy BizTalk solutions in a seamless way. So they struggle to do it, they use some open source stuff like a BizTalk deployment framework, or they use some MS Build scripts and their own way of doing things, and not having like a structured way, out of the box way to do the deployment. It's just a big pain point for a lot of them. In the same lines, the other big area is around configuration. So about binding file management, how do you manage the binding files between environments? Yes, you have this big XML file, but there is no tooling around to manage it in a nice way. And the same bucket, we put the administration side as well. So people find it really difficult to not having like a proper solution when it comes to administering and managing their BizTalk environment. So this is the number one point, deployment, configuration, and administration. Nearly 20% of the 200 people, something around 38-40 people, complained about this deployment, configuration, and admin side of things. The next big area is around analytics, reporting, visualization, graphical message flow. Those kind of things came as a next big pain point. So people think a lot of times BizTalk is just a black box. So you really don't know what's running in that environment. So you deploy your solution, and after that there is no clear way of understanding what's happening. So there is not much reporting capabilities in BizTalk out of the box. So you people try to do things like some stuff with BAM, and that's a pain point. Like a lot of times the consultants, for example, they responded they go to a customer site and they find it really harder for them to understand exactly what's going on in the environment. You know, what is the volume of messages going through the system? What is the exception rate, and all those kind of things. So that's the number two problem a lot of people complained about. And the third one is more around the development, testing, and tooling side of things. People think the tools can be improved substantially. They put some comments around the orchestration designer, improving the mapper, and the exception handling is another thing which came into the same bucket. Out of the box, there is no proper solution for people to deal with exceptions in a distributed system like BizTalk. Some people are using the ESB toolkit and the ESB exception management stuff, but that even that it's not solving the problem to the extent what they wanted to do. So they feel it will be nice if BizTalk comes out of the box with some kind of exception handling mechanism to deal with the situation. And the fourth point came around monitoring. People raised questions around it's out of the box, there is no monitoring, and when it comes to SCOM and other things, it becomes complex for them to deal with it. And majority of them, they just mentioned they got some kind of either a third party product, or they have their own custom solutions. Like even some people said they even have some VB scripts to monitor some things, a PowerShell in some cases, and things like that. So that's another big area that's been highlighted in the survey. And the fifth one is really interesting. It's quite few of them complained about it's becoming harder for them to convince the business users to say, like, you know, BizTalk is the right product to solve their problems. So whenever there is a new challenge comes along and they wanted to address it, they say, hey, BizTalk can solve the problem, but it's harder for them to convince business users. And the solution goes in the lines of the second point we discussed. It's analytics reporting capability. It's so harder to, you know, like, visualize and show to the business users, hey, this is what happening in your environment, you know, this is how we solve the problem, and these are the different, you know, performance metrics we can visualize. All those things, not having those kind of things, it makes it harder for people to convince the business users BizTalk is the right solution to address it. And apart from that, you know, like, it's all other things are all scattered all over the place. Like, people complained about low latency, some of them. And we also saw some interesting stuff like industry standard mapper, for example. You know, a lot of times people just want to use a SAP iDoc to a EDI 856 or something like that. And it's a repeatable process every time. It may be like, you know, it's a box standard mapping you need to do from that iDoc format to 856, and every time they do it themselves, so they think there is an opportunity for Microsoft to release a lot of those out of the box mapper, and people can take advantage of it. And in similar lines, some of them felt not having enough adopters. So there's a very limited set of adopters that comes out of the box. And it'll be nice to, you know, invest more and more into some of the modern adopters, like SaaS connectivity and connecting to the cloud and all those kind of things. And there's few people raised it as a pain point now to go and buy third party adopters. And the another interesting thing I noticed was around some people complained BizTalk is complex. I think that is understandable. BizTalk solves a complex problem, and they mentioned something like a lighter version, or, you know, like, the learning curve is also quite steep, and that's a general comment we received as well. So even to solve like a simple problem, like, you know, move something from a FTP location to a internal file location, requires you to understand quite a bit of the product and then the underlying architecture and all those kind of things. So they felt there could be a possibility for a lighter version of BizTalk to solve the problem. So overall, what we have understood is there is a kind of a pattern emerging, you know, like the productivity is one key problem what everyone is suffering from, you know, either the deployment productivity or development productivity or the operational productivity. These are all the areas where people are complaining about or putting it as a pain point. It would be really interesting, you know, what we can do around it, and we've been analyzing it for the last 2 months, and we have some plans to sort it out. And we will, you know, maybe I will do a following video and I'll let you know, like, you know, what are the ways we are trying to solve it. So there are a few options for us, like, you know, giving some productivity tools and maybe solving some problems by writing the white papers, and maybe solving some problems like e-books and stuff like that. And a couple of interesting ideas came as well. Like, so one guy mentioned, like, there is no document saying, you know, how can you build a secure BizTalk environment. You know, there are a lot of things you need to take care of, you know, message security, access security, if you're using credit card, then the PCI compliance, all those kind of things. So this could be easily solved by, you know, like, maybe writing a white paper. So maybe we can collaborate with the community and we can present you with a clean white paper to solve that problem. And to address some of the developer productivity, like, we can take care of some of the stuff using the BizTalk NOS we have built. And we are thinking maybe, you know, like, I don't know, give a free version or something. So I don't know. Let us think about it and come back to you on that. So I think the reason I wanted to do this video is, you know, like we did a survey and it's a bit pointless if we keep it quiet and not explain what happened. So that's the whole idea. Like I just want to spend this 10 minutes and just to go through what we have done and what we analyzed and give it back to you. So, you know, if you have anything more you want to add, you know, just put it on the comments below. And, you know, like there's always we can engage and make it really more interactive. Not just between me and you and across the entire community, and see, like, you know, how we can improve the entire ecosystem. Thank you everyone whoever participated in the survey and taken time to respond to it. It's really awesome, and we hope we can do something together. Thank you very much.